How are you? Okay. In the last video, we have started with the lesson life. Am I right? And we have discussed about the shadow. What is exactly the shadow? What are the conditions needed to form a shadow? What are the characteristics of the shadow? Yes or no? So can you just tell me what are the conditions needed to form a shadow? Yes, opaque object, opaque screen and the source of light. These three things are very important to form a shadow. Then we have discussed about the characteristics of the shadow. So what are the characteristics? The shadow is, it is always a dark. Shadow is always a dark. It only gives the outline image. It only tells you the outline image. It does not give any detailed information. Are you getting me? It does not give any detailed information. The shadow is always formed opposite to the direction of the source of light. It means, see, suppose the source of light is in front of me, my shadow will form in the back side. Am I right? My shadow will form back side. So the shadow is always formed in the opposite direction of the source of light. Then the size of shadow varies, depends on the distance between the source of light and the screen. Are you getting this? In today's video, we are going to discuss more about the shadow. We are going to discuss more in detail about the shadow. So the shadow formed by the point source. Point source means what? If the source of light is very, means for example, if you will take a laser light, are you getting? Or a torch, are you getting? It has a point source. Now, when you form an object, when the shadow will form of an object, now suppose this is a point source, I have taken a torch and this is a, suppose any opaque object, then on the screen you will get a dark patch. You will get a dark patch. So that is nothing but it is called as a, now in the last video I have told you what is meant by the dark shadow or a dark patch. The dark part is called as a umbra. It is called as a umbra. Am I right? So through the point source, if the source of a light is a point, means it is a point source of light is there, and you can get a image, that is a dark patch you will get of a shadow. So that part is called as an umbra. Now instead of point source, if I will use a large source, now example tube light or a bulb, then I will get a two region of the shadow. I will get two region, that is one I will get a dark, that is called as a umbra, and a faint part is called as a penumbra. It is called as a penumbra. This dark part I will get, that is called as a umbra, while this faint part is called as a penumbra. Okay. Now when the light will pass from this, now as a source of a light is a large. As a source of a light is a large. Now the shadow will form. See, the image or the object through, as it is a source is wide, the light can pass from all the direction. Am I right? So you will get a two shadow. You will get a two region of the shadow. That is, one you will get a dark and another you will get a faint. So that dark part is called as umbra and a faint part is called as a penumbra. Related to this shadow, the natural we can get a shadow, or we can get a concept, that is eclipse. Eclipse is an example of formation of a natural shadow. Eclipse is an example of natural formation of a shadow. Now what is that? We have already discussed, and you might have discussed in your SS3, lunar and solar eclipse. Am I right? In already in the class 5th, we have discussed about the two types of eclipse, that is lunar and solar eclipse. In the last year, you might have seen the eclipse, yes or no? We have shown the eclipse, am I right? Solar eclipse we have seen, am I right? So we are going to learn them. We are going to learn in this point, that is the formation of the shadow, okay? There are mainly the two types of eclipse, lunar and solar eclipse. Lunar and solar eclipse. In lunar eclipse, the earth comes between the sun and the moon. The earth comes between the sun and the moon. Are you getting this? Now what happens is exactly in the lunar eclipse, the earth casts the shadow on the moon. The earth casts the shadow on the moon. Now suppose when it comes in a straight line, when sun, earth and moon comes in a straight line, the whole shadow of the earth will fall on the moon. Yes or no? So this moon will not get not a single sunlight. The moon will not get a sunlight. Am I right? It will be in totally a dark part. Am I right? So that is called as a total lunar eclipse. That is called as a total lunar eclipse. And when suppose half part, if it is visible, if the half part of the moon is visible, then we call as a partial lunar eclipse. That is called as a partial lunar eclipse. Are you getting? When it is, if it is little bit upward, then this part will be in the the shadow of the earth will fall on the moon. Am I right? The shadow of the earth will fall on the moon and half part it will be visible. Are you getting? So that is called as a partial lunar eclipse. That is called as a partial lunar eclipse. Once again, during lunar eclipse, sun, earth and moon, they comes in a straight line. They comes in a straight line and what happened? Earth casts the shadow on the moon. Earth casts the shadow on the moon. Are you getting this? So this is a lunar eclipse. This is a nothing but a lunar eclipse. Now next part is of solar eclipse. This is also the formation. This is a natural formation of a shadow. The next is solar eclipse. In solar eclipse, who comes in between? The moon comes in between sun and the earth. Similar procedure is there, same thing here, but moon casts a shadow on the earth. Moon casts a shadow on the earth. Are you getting this? Now, which part? Now see, when the moon casts a shadow on the earth, now this part will be in total darkness. This part will be in total darkness. Are you getting this? So we can say here total lunar eclipse is there. Here some part is visible of light. This part you can visible. The light can be visible. Am I right? So we can say partial solar eclipse. We can say it is partial solar eclipse. Are you getting? So this part is in a total darkness. So it will, we can say here it is a total lunar, total solar eclipse. Here it is a total solar eclipse. Here the moon casts a shadow on the earth. Moon casts a shadow on the earth. These are the two types of eclipse, lunar and solar. In lunar, earth comes between sun and the moon. And in solar, moon comes between sun and the earth. Are you getting this? I hope you have understood this. In the next video, we are going to learn about the pinhole camera. We are going to learn the pinhole camera. Are you getting this? I hope you have understood this. In today's work will be, you have to write, remove the notes on the eclipse. It is there. It is there in the class 5th. It is there in the class 5th. Last year, class CBSE book that we have learned about lunar and solar eclipse. So write down in your physics notebook. Thank you.